China over many years. They have stolen our intellectual property at a rate of hundreds of billions of dollars a year. Starting on October 1st, $250 billion in goods and products from China.
Chloe!
China's been on this trajectory because it's supposedly about opening itself up to market forces, transitioning from its dogmatic form of communism to something that looks more like a market system. And a key landmark was in 2001, China gets the right to enter the World Trade Organization, which gives China access to export markets of the world at very low tariffs. And in exchange, China's supposed to open up its market to international competition. China's supposed to allow, essentially, market forces to play a much greater role in its economic life. And ever since then, American presidents have gone to China, and they have criticized China for failing to live up to the terms of the deal, for continuing to run a state-dominated economy in which major Chinese companies serve interests of the Chinese Communist Party leadership, where they get subsidies and other perks. And so here is the President of the United States essentially treating American business not unlike a Chinese state-owned company. Hey, Microsoft and Amazon and Apple and whoever else, you work for me, I'm the boss, and I'm telling you it's time to get out of China.
So all of that is the backdrop for the summit, which starts on Saturday. What actually happens?
So Saturday, Trump lands in France, and in between meetings, he's telling anyone who will listen that really does have the ability to force American companies to leave China. Mm-hmm. There's this obscure law that nobody's ever heard of.
Well, in 1977, we had an act passed, the National Emergency Act. I have the absolute right to do that. We'll see how that goes, but I have the absolute right. 1977, check it out.
Then that night, he's the last world leader to arrive at an informal dinner with the rest of the leaders. And he's asked about the economy. He says, I think we're doing very well. We're having a little spat with China, and we'll win it. And then on Sunday, we get this revealing, sort of confusing window into how Trump is thinking about this when he's asked at a press conference whether he has any regrets. And the world explodes with this.
We begin tonight with President Trump's surprising comments about his escalating trade war with China just hours before the stock markets open in the U.S.
For a president who rarely, if ever, expresses regret, today in France, President Trump made what seemed to be a surprising admission.
And there's tremendous analysis that Trump is actually backing down. Trump has second thoughts.
The American president hinted he regrets escalating his trade war with China. He told reporters he has doubts about ratcheting up his tariff fight with China.
Well, there's so much of this speculation that it prompts the White House to issue a clarification.
White House Press Secretary Stephanie Grisham put an entirely different spin on the president's words, issuing this statement. His answer has been greatly misinterpreted. President Trump responded in the affirmative because he regrets not raising the tariffs higher.
Did you find that speculation to be a little overheated? I thought one way of interpreting that was just the president saying, yeah, sure, I second-guess myself. Who does? Which is perhaps a sign of just how important this trade war is. That even the slightest hint of self-doubt or vulnerability can swing billions of dollars.
Well, that's right. That's absolutely right. And yet, we're dealing with a president who is very confident about sitting in front of a bunch of reporters and just sort of musing on the dynamic.
And also very big